getting a load of comments on the channel about what if you change the size of your wheels on your e-mountain bike. Well, it's a very complex subject, but today we're going to look at the options and what effect it has on your geometry and handling of your bike. But why then would you do it? Well, changing wheel size creates a different ride dynamic and a different feel to your e-mountain bike. But it's important not to confuse feeling with fact, because a lot of the time, the larger 29-inch wheels are actually quicker, and they're certainly quicker when it comes to muddy conditions. Now, if you swap between the two, between 29 and 27.5, the 27.5 can actually feel a little bit more lively, a little bit more nervy, but it all comes down to adaption. If you spend a considerable amount of time on the two wheel sizes, you soon adapt to each. Now, we actually spend a lot of time between all the different wheel sizes. For example, we've got 27.5 on the Kinevos, 29 on the Levos, and actually a mix of wheel sizes, 29 inch up front and 27.5 on the rear of our Canyon Spectrals. Now, one really important question to ask is, can your bike actually accommodate a different wheel size? Now, it's important to look in the chainstay area of your bike. Can you actually fit a 29 inch wheel into a 27.5 inch frame? And if you're going from 29 to 27.5 with bigger tires, can a 2.8 or 3 inch tire get inside that chainstay? Obviously, you've got the front of the bike to consider as well. Now, a lot of the time, you can fit a 27.5 wheel into a 29-inch fork. However, can you fit a 29-inch front wheel into a 27.5 fork? It's gonna be very, very tight. And maybe some manufacturers will frown upon you doing that as well. Some more important considerations to think about are your axle sizes, both front and rear. Check they are both compatible. And more importantly, what happens when the rear suspension is compressed? Now, what can happen with some bikes, if you do fit a 29-inch wheel to a 27.5-inch frame, if you compress the suspension, it will actually touch the seat tube. So the way to find out if there's any contact between the wheel and the frame is to let the air out of your rear damper, or take the coil off your damper and compress the suspension fully to see if there's any contact, as I said, between the wheel and that seat tube. In general then, 27.5 wheels will feel more nimble and nervy than 29, which in turn will feel more stable and roll through rough ground faster. But essentially, it's only a feeling, and most riders can adapt to either wheel size pretty quickly, which can also be said for the mix and match wheel size option. It all comes down to geometry. Now, a lot of the time, a bike is actually designed to suit one wheel size. Yes, it can accommodate a bigger or smaller wheel, but the suspension and the geometry is actually tuned to work for that bike. However, it can be done and it can work in certain situations. Right then, so what are your options in terms of wheels? Right, you've got 27.5, you've got 29, and on our Canyon Spectral on, we have 29 inch front and 27.5 rear. And remember, the first World Cup downhill of the year was won by Loic Bruni on that mixed wheel size mullet style bike. Right then, so what actually will be the effects to the geometry if you swap wheel sizes between your bikes? So let's start off with, say, an average 150mm travel bike with 29 inch wheels fitted to it. It'll have, say, a 338mm bottom bracket with a 67 degree head angle. Now, the first thing you need to think about is what the characteristics of those wheels are going to be. 29-inch wheels generally roll faster. They definitely roll faster over square edge hits. You might be over jumping stuff. They require different braking points in corners and are really good in wet conditions. Now, what's going to happen then if you swap out that rear wheel for a 27.5 and leave the 29-inch wheel up front? Well, as I mentioned earlier, Loic Bruni won the first World Cup downhill of the year with this mullet-style setup. However, there's lots of things to take into account if you're doing this. The first thing depends on actually the size of the tire you fit on the rear, because you can actually have between a 5 and 10mm difference just between tire choice alone. However, on average, you can expect the bottom bracket to drop between 6 to 10mm and that head angle to go from, say, 67, which you had on 29-inch wheels, down to about 65, 66 with a smaller inch wheel on the back. It's going to have a big impact on the handling of the bike as well. When you go into corners, that low bottom bracket is definitely going to help you get around the corners quicker. And because of the smaller back wheel you're going to probably get into the tighter corners a little bit faster. Right, this is where things get a little bit confusing. Now, what if you swap to 27.5 front and rear? Because if you do that, you can expect up to 15 millimeter drop on the bottom bracket, which is actually really significant. But again, it depends on that tire. Now, if you, for example, if you put a 2.4 tire on the back and a 2.8 tire up front, that's gonna give you a slightly tilted ride, but the head angle is not gonna be quite as extreme as if you'd have done that with the 27.5 back and 29-inch wheel front. When it comes to riding, that 2.8 front tire is gonna be really gonna be of benefit when you ride in rough, worn out trail centers. And in general, you're gonna get a really balanced ride. And that bottom bracket at 325 on average is gonna be absolutely lightning through the corners. Now, in our final example, we've actually swapped 27.5 front and rear, and we've put 2.8 tires on both front and rear as well. The good thing about the 2.8 tires, they provide really good cushioning, especially when you're on those blown out forest trails. And of course, you've got that great traction from that big rear tire. The impact and geometry. Now remember, all these are examples, they're averages of what you might expect if you change wheel sizes and tire sizes. So we've actually now gone from a 338 millimeter bottom bracket and a 67 degree head angle on the 29, down to 329 millimeter bottom bracket and a 66 degree head angle on this 27.5, the 2.8 tires. So again, you've seen a lowering of the bottom bracket, but the head angle is actually quite close to how it was with the 29-inch wheels on it. So it's actually quite close to the 29-inch wheel bike, which is quite different to what a lot of people think. So there you go, a minefield of numbers and head angles to deal with if you're changing the wheel size on your e-mountain bike, let alone all those different tire combinations and tread patterns. Now, as you can see, my numbers went down to 325 millimeters. And if you want to compare that to, say, a non-e-bike, look at the current 2019 Specialized Stump Jumper, which is 150 mil travel. And a lot of the e-bikes we ride are 150 mil travel. That has a 328 bottom bracket for the 29-inch version and a 324 millimeter bracket, bottom bracket for the 27.5-inch version. So the numbers are pretty much in the ballpark. If you look at our Specialized Levos at the moment, they're 347 millimeter bottom bracket. Sorry to bombard you with all these numbers, but as you can see, at 347, you can easily drop down to a 27.5 wheel size there and go down to about 340 mil on the bottom bracket. What then is too low? Well, we seem to be in an era where different brands are working things out when it comes to e-bike specific geometry. Things such as the chainstay, if you look at the Rocky Mountain Powerplay, 420 mil chainstay, Mondraker Level, 480 mil chainstay, and that's gonna have a big effect on the dynamic handling of those bikes. What then about bottom brackets? Now, everyone's thinking at the moment, what is the optimum bottom bracket on an e-bike? Our Levos, like I said, is 347, but that's actually quite low compared to, say, Ducati with a 465 millimeter bottom bracket height. Obviously, you could swap out the 29-inch wheels for a 27.5 on that particular frame set. The general message here is actually to look at your own individual e-bike geometry and see if it can be modified by changing the wheel size. And I hate to say it, but some bikes can actually be improved by changing the geometry. But make sure you've got that space. For example, you've got a 320 millimeter bottom bracket on a 150 mil travel bike, then clearly you will not be able to go from 29-inch wheels to 27.5 because the bottom bracket will simply be touching the ground. And we can actually include that low bottom bracket into our summary about changing wheel sizes and how it affects the dynamic handling of your e-bike. First of all, cornering. Now, lower brackets in general mean you're going to corner far more efficiently than high bottom brackets. So what happens when it comes to climbing? Now, if you remember earlier, we mentioned we had a 27.5 wheel on the rear and a 29-inch wheel on front. That's going to lead to a more downhill specific geometry on that bike. And what it does, it creates a rearward weight bias, which is going to affect the way you climb your e-bike. So you might need to do such things as lock out the shock on your bike, or as I mentioned, if your bike has a really steep C-tube angle, then it might be quite good anyway. And when it comes to that all-important descending, now, we know that 27.5-inch wheels descend really well. That's assuming the geometry on the bike is really good. But what if you go for the larger 29-inch wheels? Well, I think when you get moved to then, it comes down to you as the rider, how high you are, because some short riders actually have problems with their bums touching the back wheel when it comes to the steep descents. And finally, don't forget that if you do change your wheel size, then maybe you'll need to reconfigure your motor on your e-bike as well, which you can do in the settings. And it all depends on the brand of bike you have. So there you go, wheels, wheel sizes, tires, different tread patterns. It's a world there to be explored. If you want to see more about geometry, there's a video on e-bike geometry explained. I really want to know what you guys think about changing wheel sizes. Any questions you have, so please leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you like the video, hit the globe to subscribe.